On some station there's two, on this station there's one. This is the walrus walk. So they're gonna lay on their belly on the scooter and they're gonna pull themselves all the way across with the jump rope. Now this could be a little bit tricky, but it's really good to work on their arm muscles. When they're done, they're going to gently slide it back for the front of you. Can you slide it back? Thank you. Okay, on the high beam, they have two choices. They can do a giraffe walk, which is up really tall on their tippy toes, or they can do a chicken walk, and you can let them pick what a chicken walk is like. I'm not too particular about that, it's just for fun. So you walk all the way to the end. Good chicken walk. And at the end, we're gonna jump down and land in our safety stop and ta-da. Very good. On the zigzag line, they again have two choices for a crab walk or a lizard walk. For a crab walk, make sure that their bellies are up to the ceiling, which is perhaps. And they're using their arm muscles to hold themselves up. This is a really great start for a bridge and for a table. A lizard crawl can be any number of things. Again, this one's just for fun. Becca's lizard crawl definitely has bent legs, and she looks like a chameleon. I love it. The last station, the low beam, they have the choice of a bear crawl or an inchworm. The difference between the bear crawl and the inchworm is bear crawl hands and feet move at the same time. Inchworm, they're gonna move their hands and then move their feet, but not both at the same time. Whichever one you want. Straight legs. And that's it for our beam circuit.